everybody, and welcome to Push Your Luck Podcast video review. Today we'll be looking at a micro game all the way from Japan called Hatari. Now this is from Jun Sasaki, and who owns, published by Oink Games. You can go to the website, oinkgms.com. You can also follow them on Twitter. Now, the micro games has been quite a rage, quite a rage recently. Yeah, a lot of people are liking micro games, and most of the micro games are from Japan. Of all the micro games that we've been playing, I think the micro games from Jun Sasaki and from Oink Games have been some of our favorites. Jonathan and I both love games from Oink Games. They have very good high quality, but he doesn't really make a lot of them. It's only maybe 1,000 or 500 runs. So but I'll always keep the website on my browser, and whenever I see a new game, I'll quickly go and buy one because I've been enjoying the game so far, and Hatari is no different. So let's take a look at what this deductive game, this plays 2-4, plays very fast, I think 15 minutes or so. Let's see what this game is like, how it plays, and my thoughts.
So this is what you get for Hatari. The box is quite small, but it's quite a good quality cardboard. You can see that everything is nicely done. I mean, I really like the quality that games from Japan come up with. I mean, it's really nice quality, very high quality. I'm always very happy, satisfied with games from Japan. These are the 8 different character cards. I would say that are people that you get in a game. These are shaped to be like a person, symbolically shaped like a person. And they are very nice thick cardboards as well. You get 8 of them. Numbers are blank, 2 all the way to 8. Now take note that the number 5 is a bit special, is red and has a switch symbol. I'll explain what it does later. Each player will also have 5 of this accusation chips. 5 of them. All right, this will be used throughout the game. So how do you play the game? At the start, this plays 2-4. So at the start, if you're playing 4 players, none of this will be out. If you're playing 3 or 2 players, the number 2 and number 8 will be out. So if you're playing 4 players, you take all these things, you shuffle them, and then you randomly will deal out 1 out to each of the players. So 1, 2, 3, 4. In the middle, you put 1 as a victim, and you place 3 suspects. So these are the suspects we're trying to accuse and guess correctly. Each player will take the one that they have in front of them, look at the number, and pass it to your right. Then you take the one that the player has just passed, player to the left has just passed you, you open up and see. So now you have 2 pieces of information out of the 8 possible tiles that are on the board. Beginning with start player, whoever has this is a start player. This is a special start player token because it reminds you the play should then go in a clockwise direction. So beginning with start player, will take one of his chits. Start player will choose to look at 2 of the 3 suspects. So the start player, the player will then take both of them, take a look at them, take a look at the numbers, and then put them back in the same order that he took them from again. So you should not switch the order that they're in. Take one of these purple ones, place it on the suspect you did not see. So this will indicate to everyone that this is the suspect you did not see. Next, the start player has a choice to switch the victim with one of the suspects. Now this is a bit detached from the theme of the game where you're trying to figure out who the suspects are. It's optional as well. You can play with or without this. So the start player can choose. Let's say for example he decides to do it. He'll switch the victim with one of the suspects. And then he'll place this on top to indicate to everyone this was the one that was switched. Now he cannot look at this again. Alright. I think this is to make sure that you can factor this in to add more randomness to the game. But the player who switched cannot look at this again. So now the start player will take one of these chips and place on one of these 3 suspects. So this is where he's trying to either accuse, trying to guess correctly, or bluff and hope that someone else will fall into his trap. So he'll place one here, for example. Now, the next player, it's now the next player's turn. The next player can look at only two out of the 3. Which 2 can he look at? He can only look at the 2 that was not accused by the player before him, by the immediate player before him or her. Which means that the next player after the orange player can only look at these 2 suspects now. So he'll take and look at these two suspects, and then he or she will then take one of his sheets and also place it onto one of the suspects. He can place it on the same suspect again, putting his cheat on top, or he can put it somewhere else. So the next player, now let's say for example the green player, he cannot look at the one that the blue player has accused. He can only look at this two. So this goes on until four players have already placed their cheats onto the suspects. Then all the players will review the three suspects to see who is right and who is wrong. Now, typically, if this was the case, usually the number that's highest will be the correct suspect. If there was a blank is always innocent. All right. So in this case, this is 7 is the suspect. So the blue player will take his chip back because he accused correctly. The yellow player will take his chip back and flip over, becomes a black mark, becomes a liar side. All right. That means he guessed wrongly, so he takes his back. This can no longer be used to accuse now. It becomes a black mark in his area. Now, this is interesting. If there's two of them who guess wrongly, whoever is the player on top, for this case will be the green player, he'll take both chips back and flip them over, become two black spots in his area. Okay. Now, players will check whether the endgame condition has been met. If a player has 8 chips in total, be it accusation chips or liar chips, then he will lose. The game will end and he's the biggest loser. Otherwise, if a player only has liar chips left, he has no more accusation chips left, then he becomes the biggest loser. If no one has met these two conditions, play continues until you reset everything again, shuffle everything again, deal out everything again, and then play continues until one of these two endgame conditions are met. Then basically you see who is the biggest loser. You can also try see who's the winner by seeing who has the least number of liar chips, for example. That could also be a way to play the game. So that's in a gist, this is a game of Hatari. So let me
now, as I mentioned, I really like Jun Sasaki-san's games from Oink Games. They're all very nicely produced. They come in nice box. If you go on the line, you can see they come in this nice sort of like a gift package. Right, you can store all his games inside. I will also be reviewing the other two games that you see here later on. But trust us when we say that the games are very fun. Hatari is a simple deductive game where you're trying to guess. You have some information, then you're trying to guess who the suspect is. In addition, you can also sabotage other people. You can lay traps, you can trick other people. Depending on how you play, you can create more confusion because, for example, let's say if the person did not see the number 5 and you happen to see number 5, if you block it, that person may not guess correctly because number 5, oh, I forgot to mention, sorry, if the number 5 comes out, it means that the three suspects, the lowest number now becomes a suspect rather than the highest number. So this adds a more variety to the game as well. So as you can tell, I really like the game. The components are nice, very nicely produced. It's very fun. It's a quick 15-minute game where players are trying to guess. It works your brain out, surprisingly, for such a light game. So if you have a chance, most of the time he sells his games online. Go to oinkgms.com. If you see it as, you can try use Chrome because it has a Google Translate for you. And you can order the games. Otherwise, you can always email him directly. He's quite responsive. He answers emails and you can order games. Shipping might be a bit expensive because he ships from Japan after all. And but if you have a chance, do get his games. I really like his games and I will review the other two games in future video episodes. So do give it a try. If you really like micro games, you like fast, quick games, you can play during the lunchtime. And it's deductive, it does allow you to use your brain as well. Do give Hatari a try from Oink Games. Thank you!